Hey guys, in this video we'll be covering some of the effects in Reaper. This video will go over the compressor, delay, and equalizer plugins. The plugins tutorial for Reaper has been split into two parts and we'll cover a few more in the next video. Before getting started, just make sure you've checked out the previous videos in this series. The first plugin we have to work with is the compressor, called ReaComp in Reaper. Compression is used to control the dynamics of an audio track. That means the volume level. The compressor can be used to decrease the dynamic range by lowering the volume level when it passes a threshold, and you can make the track punch through or smooth out by changing the attack and release. Let's start with how we can use this plugin. At the top, there's a dropdown that we can use to change the preset for the plugin. Even if we choose a preset, we can make adjustments to the settings so that we can use it as a starting point instead. The first control for the compressor is the threshold. The threshold sets the level the compression will start to be applied at. When the sound level passes the threshold, compression starts to be applied and the volume level is reduced. Next up, we have some timing controls. The compressor doesn't have to activate immediately when the threshold is reached, and it also doesn't have to deactivate right away when the signal drops back below the threshold. The attack allows the compressor to come on gradually if it's set high, or it can be set low and the compressor will turn on abruptly. The release is similar to the attack, but it sets how fast the compressor turns off when the signal level drops. The precomp can act as a look ahead in this case to apply compression slightly before the audio level peaks. The auto release box below can be selected to prevent the compressor from releasing suddenly. The ratio helps us determine the amount of gain reduction applied once the threshold is exceeded. Let's consider a ratio of 3. If we have a signal that's 3 above the threshold, it will be reduced to 1 above. If the signal goes 9 above, it will be reduced to 3 above. The knee size allows the ratio to change gradually around the threshold, but can be left as an abrupt change if the knee is set to 0. Classic attack allows the ratio to reduce as the volume level increases so that high-level sounds are not compressed. Down below, we can set what signal the compressor uses as its reference for the audio level. The dropdown allows us to select the main input or an auxiliary input if we want to use sidechain compression instead. To set up a sidechain, we need to do a little signal routing first. Go to the track signal routing that we're working on. At the top, select for there to be 4 track channels instead of 2. This allows it to receive an auxiliary input from another track without playing that audio, and tracks 3 and 4 will be used as the detector input. Then set up a receive from another track as we did in the previous video. When you set the receive, you'll see audio 1/2 with an arrow going to audio 1/2. We need to change this so it goes to the auxiliary input instead of the main inputs, that way it's not heard. Change where it's going to 3/4. Now that receive is playing on 3/4 instead. We can't hear it, but it will now be detected by the auxiliary input on our plugins. The low pass sets the maximum frequency the detector will use, and the high pass sets the lowest. RMS size works to average out the levels over time that it detects. The preview filter box on the right allows us to compare the low pass and high pass versus the sound without it. To the right, we have a gain reduction meter. Next to that is the output level meter. The wet mix is usually left at 0 unless you're adding makeup gain, and the dry level is set to minus infinity. We can also use the auto makeup gain instead to compensate for the loss volume. Last, there's a limit output box that we can use to set the compressor as a hard limiter, even if we push the volume with the output level control. Our next plugin is ReaDelay, which is a delay plugin. Once again, there are a few presets at the top, but I prefer to work from scratch when using a delay plugin. The cool thing about this plugin is that we can have multiple delays within the same plugin. The first option is wet and dry mix, so we can increase or decrease the volume of the original and delayed signal. We can also change the volume of the individual delays. At the bottom, we have options to add or delete a tap, which are basically just separate delays. They can be switched between with the notches at the top. At the top, we can turn the delay on or off with the enable button or solo it from all other delays. Next, we can set the length as time in milliseconds or musical time. Only use one of these and set the other to 0. Feedback will add a small amount of the delayed signal back into the original dry signal to be reprocessed. High and low pass filters adjust the frequencies that the delay is applied to. Resolution is used to change the bit depth of the wet signal. The stereo width can be used to narrow the stereo width of a stereo track that has delay. The volume is used to adjust the volume of the individual delay taps so that we can get a balance between them. We can also pan them with the slider on the right. Then you can use the wet and dry mix to get a balance between all the taps and the dry signal. The ReaEQ is the included equalizer in Reaper, and it's another one of the important plugins that will be used in most mixes. Equalization allows you to cut and boost certain ranges of frequencies on a track to shape the sound and allow them to fit together nicely. The default is 4 bands that can be switched between in the same way as we saw for the delay plugin. We can also add bands, delete bands, reset defaults, and turn the grid view on and off. Let's cover how to adjust the individual bands. The first box allows us to turn a band on and off. Then we have type. We can switch between a normal band and a few other types. The low and high shelf allow us to cut or boost all the low frequencies. The high pass cuts out all the low frequencies, and the low pass cuts out all the high frequencies. These are more drastic changes with a sharper frequency drop-off than the shelf type. There's a few other types, like a notch, that can cut out specific frequencies that are worth experimenting with. Each band of the EQ has a frequency control, gain, and bandwidth that sets the width of the change around a central frequency. All of these controls can be adjusted by clicking and dragging on the circles that appear on the EQ grid. Dragging left and right controls the frequency, up and down the gain, and the bandwidth is controlled with a scroll wheel on the mouse. Lastly, there's a gain control on the side to either add or reduce gain to the track after the EQ is added. Thanks for checking out this video on some of the plugins available in Reaper. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for social media links to stay up to date on all our new content.